information about them on the other side. So there was this very detailed school project plan, like the grade or so. So I decided, instead of taking the pictures, firstly I had to draw them out. You know, there were like this 10 personalities of the poets, I believe. So I decided to draw them out, draw the portraits of them, and I completed the project and I got a standing ovation. So my teachers in school observed all this, and there was this parent teacher conference, interaction one day, and my teacher told my parents that your daughter is very good at art, computers and art. This is the exact words which my parents told my, my teachers told my parents. What my parents thought was, computers only. The art part was totally checked out. Why? Because, you know, art is something which people see as a hobby. You know, people ask me, what do you do? Though I'm still a student, I tell them I'm an artist, I go for a living. Okay, boy, yeah, you manage to draw a background up on the wall, you know, you see the last page of my notebooks. You see a lot of drawing. Yes, you did. I mean, everybody has drawn things at any one point of life, but I continue to take it. Continue to draw for throughout my life, and I made it as a profession, and I get to live the dream of being illustrated by drawing for the day. So, when my parents heard that she's good at computers and art, the computers part was taken completely into their head, and hence I was made to draw in engineering. So I'm still pursuing it. I'm in my third year of engineering. So, the art part, when teachers told it, it was somewhere in the hanging in the middle of nowhere like this, and totally checked out the little part. We all have been in childhood, we all are like all the 96, because I believe you all are musicians like me. So when we have a child, we have lots of different dreams, right? We want to be a doctor or an astronaut, or even I want to become a monk at one point of time after our parents and all. So we all might have been like, okay, I want to be this, I want to be that. So all what I enjoyed when I was a child was making art. You know, when you go to the beach, you can't remain on the sand, or you build a sand castle. So when you go to the beach, you know, you see the sand as a canvas to make art. For artists like me, the whole world is a canvas. When I see a bare white wall, I get an urge inside my mind to go splash colors on that. So that is the mentality of an artist I have maintained it so far. And I couldn't have had a better life, or I couldn't have asked for a more colorful life. And now I'm an illustrator, and I get to live the dream by going for a living, and my life is colorful like this. Colors is everywhere. And every day I work with colors and paints and everything related to art, and I couldn't ask for more. Every day is like a colorful start of my life. So that's the story of an artist's life. So moving on, making art isn't a new thing to me at all. Art has many forms, right? Like in cooking is an art. Mom, like she cooks so much in the kitchen, and you know, art is something which is abstract. You know, I come from a state called Bangalore in South India, and the murals on the streets is a very common thing which you can see. And not just the murals, you know, there are many ancient paintings which are very abstract, and you actually don't get what the meaning of that. You know, art, if you don't understand it, then art is doing its work definitely. So take for example, I think the cooking is an art. If your mom cooks a delicious food and you don't understand what she's put in it, definitely the art is working there. So I made this illustration a few years ago, and it was some random girl sitting on a hot ball of fire gazing at the red sky, and it was absolutely abstract. What I highlighted was on the hair, because I had really short hair back then. So it is abstract. Art is abstract, and there are so many forms of art which is seen every day. Like singing is an art, cooking is an art, even hosting a program is an art. Art, talking, developing a good talk is an art. So it is amazing how two forms of art, or you know, various types of art, can connect to each other. I have a friend modern form of education, like smart education, projectors and all that, even in schools. So basically what the concept is, verbal knowledge, verbal education can be implemented more effectively by digital knowledge. I'll show you a small example. This was the 7 pointers which was given by one of my clients. It was world that they are a firm in Gurgaon where they take care of pet grooming and stuff. So it was World Dogs Day and we wanted to illustrate 7 things which people learn from their dogs. Okay, so most of you here might not even have cared to read all the 7 points. So the same paragraph, which is in verbal form, I illustrated it in a visual form like this. And it's really more persuasive to the people. Why I use art and my propaganda is because it's persuasive to people and it's multivariate. Pointers can be converted into persuasive illustrations to make it reach out to people even more. So, possibly that is why this smart education has been taken over in the schools as well. It's amazing how modern, how the ancient art has been given the strength of technology and has been converted to modern art. I'm not very familiar with visual effects and motion graphics, but I recently tried out giving some movement to one of my graphic art, and it became something like this. It's called a graphic in thin format. I managed to do this in everywhere in Facebook, the game files. So it's a new form of art, you know. The more you experiment on it, the more you